Hello and welcome. We just floated a company with the name Remote Africa today. For those of us that are developing, those of us that are software developers, as of now we're working on setting up the company in the right way, including changing the name, giving it a very good name, as well as setting up the various departments and getting to work. And as I speak now, we already have some few jobs that we will start with. And we are not expecting so much in terms of rewards and finances yet, but with time we expect those to fall in place. So I want to welcome all those that are on board. It's restricted already because the number that we wanted, we already have the number already. So I'm not going to be putting out the how you can join again because we already have enough numbers. But just know that we already have this company floated. And if you have any job software, have a small website that you want to be created for you, can send them in. We'll do them. We have so many professionals across Nigeria and Africa to help you handle any software project that you have. So if you have any work, you want to create a website, want to create a software, want to create a startup, fintech, any form of startup that you want, you can always send them across and work on them for you. So that is it. But we're going to continue with our Boston coding interview questions, and we're going to be looking at anagrams. So the question says, check to see if two provided strings are anagrams of each other. So you are given two strings, string A and string B. You want to check whether two of them are anagrams of each other. And in order to do that, we need to give some examples. One string is an anagram of another if it uses the same characters in the same quantity. Only consider characters, not spaces. So in this, we are not going to be considering spaces or punctuations. Consider capital letters to be the same as lower letters. So these are examples. Rail safety is the same as fairy tales because we have one R here. We also have one R here. We have double A, 1, 2. We also have two A's here. So this is why these two are anagrams. These two are also anagrams, though we are having exclamation marks here, but we are not having here. But they are because we are not considering exclamation marks, that's why both of them are anagrams. But these two are not, because they are not using the same combination of words. That's why we have force here. So we're going to get started immediately. And for us to get started, I'm going to give a space. This is where we're supposed to write the function. But before we start writing this function, we're going to write a simple function that is going to build a character map for the two supply strings. So that once we build the character maps, we can easily compare. So we're going to call this function. We're going to call it build char map. So that's the function we're going to, the helper function that we're going to be using. So we're going to put into it a string. So once we supply string, it's going to be able to build a character map for us. I'm going to open up this so that I can write this function. So this function is going to, we're going to have const char map. So this is what is going to be building. So it's going to build this constant. And it's simply going to, this char map is actually an object. So it's going to build up the properties or the elements of this object and put it inside this object. So how do we go about building it? We're going to say for, and we're going to say let char. So for every character of the string. So what string are we looking at? The string that is supplied. So we're going to be using a regular expression to replace everything when we search through a word. So what we're going to do is search through a word, and that is the regular expression that we're going to be using to search through a word. So you can look up regular expressions to see how to go about this. So search through a word and find all the punctuations and other characters that are not needed. Search through them and replace them with empty space. That's what you do. So that's what this regular expression does. Search through and replace every punctuation and any other thing that you don't need and replace it with empty space. So having done that, what should we then do? So if we've converted everything to be remaining only viable characters, what do? We now change to lowercase. Because like we said, lowercase or uppercase shouldn't be a problem in it. So convert all to lowercase. So that's what we're gonna do. And once we do that, we are good to go. So once we do that, we are now going to write this simple function. And what is going to be happening inside this, what we are going to be iterating through is char map. And we're going to be checking each of the characters. So once we check each of the character, we are going to add it up by saying char map you know what this means. When you have the same thing here and here, it simply means that anything you have, that you should add it up to what is here and also equate it to that. So that's what we are going to do. So once you find anyone, you should simply add it up. Add one, make an increment to it. Then if not, like if you've not checked through that character for the first time, then you should just call that character the first one. So that is what this statement is doing. So once you've done this, you should then do what? Return the what? Char map. So once you've built this character map, return it. So that's how we're going to be building character maps with string A and string B. So once you build this character map, you can now be able to compare the two. So that's why we wrote this function, build char map, build character map. So build character map, that's the meaning. And it's going to be taking in the string. And once it takes the string, we're going to be having an empty object that is going to be built up. And how are we going to do the building up? By saying for let any character off this string. And before we do take on this string, we need to have worked on it. And how do we work on it? By replacing all punctuations, like we said here, capital letters, we said here that only consider characters, not spaces or punctuations. So this regular expression is going to take care of every space and punctuation and replace it with an empty character or empty string. Then make it lowercase. So that's what it does. So for every character in this string that has been worked on, please pick out the each of the character. You understand? Then check whether if it is the first one that you've not attributed through, call it one. But if it's subsequent one, just add one to it. So if you have H, you should have one as the number. If you have another H, you should now have two as the number. So that's how you're gonna be building out this character string. So once it's built, we can now start writing the main function, and that's what we are going to try and do now. So now we've returned our character map. What do we do now? So how do we use it to work? How can we use this to work? And we can only do that inside the main anagram function. So to do that, I simply say const the first one that we have built, the first character map that we built out of string A, and we're going to call it A H char map. That's the character map that we're going to be building from string A. We're going to call it H char map, and we're going to equate it to build. You know, we've already written this function, build char map. So where are you building this char map from? You're actually building it from string A. So that is how we do that. I hope you understand. We are using the helper function to build this char map. So having done that, it's also good that we build the one for the second one, which we are going to call consp trial map. This for the second one. So we're going to also build it using the helper function by saying build trial map. Later I'm going to be giving us a diagrammatic explanation of what this trial map, this character map is, so that we can have a better understanding of them. So we're going to be building this from string B. So those are the two character maps that we are going to be building. So after building this character map, what do we do? We now say if object dot keys, if object dot keys. Now you check the first one, a char map, object dot keys, a char map dot length. So you're checking the length of this character map, the first character map, which is a char map. You check the length and see whether it is equal to that of the second one, because if they are not equal, then there's no need going through the whole process of checking order whether they match actually. So they have to be equal. So if they are not equal, then there's no need going on. So we'll check it first and see. So object dot keys of the second one, which is b char map, okay, dot length. So we'll check the two to see whether they are equal. So if they are not equal, what's going to happen? If they are not equal, you're simply going to return false. That's the first thing we'll do. Now, if they are equal, that means you're not going to return false. So what are we going to do? We're going to now say for let character or char in. Whenever you use for let in, then you're checking through objects, and we're using let in for in statement because we actually want to check object. Why are we checking object? Because we actually built object from the build char map. The build char map actually builds objects for us. So that's why we're checking through the object, and the object we are checking through is a char map. So if we check through this object, what are we expected to do? We are supposed to check if a char map, the very character we are considering in a char map, the very character, we'll consider it, and after the consideration, it is not equal to B. It is not equal to B char map. That very same character, the one we are considering for B, we are considering the first. We are considering the first for the two. We are considering the second. We are also considering the second for the two. So if we check that for A and that for B, and they are not the same thing, what do? We simply return false. That's what we do. But if we checked and they are the same, what do? Which is the final thing that we do? We simply return true. We simply return true. And with that, we'll finish this function. So check out what we did first. First of all, we wrote this helper function that builds character map. And this character map is actually an object. You can see it with the curly bracket. So we declare this character map. We say for let a of string. Before we chose this string, we had to use regular expression to replace all spaces and punctuations with empty string. Then we change it to a lowercase. So we check the first one, and we'll count the number. If it is the first one, we'll call it one. If it is not the first one, we add one to it. So for the very character we're checking, if you're checking heads, we'll do that for heads, so that we can find out the number of heads that are in that word. If you're checking for E, we also do that for E, find out the number of E. So this is actually building an object of key value pairs. So the key is the word you're looking at, the value is the number that it appeared. So after that, we now declare the character mouse for A and for B using the string. So we're using this string to build our character mouse. And for A, we call it A comma, for B, we call it B comma. Then after that, before we start checking to see whether the number that is in a word, say A, matches with that of the number of that same word in the character map of B, we need to know whether both of them have the same length, and that's what we did here. So if they don't have the same length, we'll just call it false, then we'll stop. But if they have the same length, now we'll now do this, we'll check each word. So if we have hello and we have, let's say we have these two words, red safety and red, we have to check the first, we have to check for R first. So if we check, then we'll see that we check the character map for R, for character map of A and B. If we have the number of R in A to be equal to that in B, if they are not equal, this first statement says they are not equal. If they are not equal, you return false. But if they are equal, we now return true. But you know that you have to have iterated through the whole of A chap map and through the whole of B chap map before you can confidently say whether it is false or true. So that's how you do anagram. Remember, we say that anagram simply means using the same word the same number of times for two different strings, and that is what we checked here. We're going to explain what this anagram is in subsequent in future videos, so that you actually understand what character maps are, because you need the knowledge of character maps for you to understand how this code actually works. Thank you and God bless you.